Hello again, YouTubers. Jason Lawrence here. Last video I took was about 2 hours ago, and we were looking in the range of about 4 volts, I believe, using the solar panel that I've got connected with this rather rough hack setup, and simply trickle charging. The last time I tried to connect my battery charger, which is a Pulsetech pulsing charger, it tested a bad battery, which is common if the voltage is too low. I found with this particular device, if I am able to bump up the voltage somewhere above zero, then I can trick the circuitry in this system to begin charging it. And so far, it seems to see this battery setup, or this power pack, as a battery, and it's charging it as though it's 25%, and now here we are at 12 volts already. So what's interesting too here is it's drawing about 43 watts from the wall. About 60 hertz, which is what we would expect. About a 0.6 power factor, which isn't great for efficiency, but I don't totally understand that setup. A lot of motors are right around 0.99 if they're a super efficient motor. So far I've been having it go for about 4 minutes. It's drawing about almost 7/10 of an amp, and then line voltage obviously there at about 112. Seems to go down around this time of day, and that may have something to do with local conditions, but there we are at 43 watts, showing 25% on the Pulsetech, and showing now 12.5 volts on the multimeter. And I'm going to set this up so that you can watch me go through a balancing sequence test. Hopefully I can set up the multimeter so that you can see that. And I just have this particular lead wedged. So I'll use this as a setup. Hopefully you'll be able to see that. Okay, so I'll tip it just to the side. So I'm going to go through each of these pairs, and you'll be able to see the voltage in each one. So the first one down here at the bottom, it's about 1.9. The next one, it's about 1.8. Next one, about 1.9. So they seem to be balanced relatively well. 1.9. This guy back here previously was showing about a 10% higher, 1.97. So almost two, consistently still about 10% higher than the others. Maybe due to its internal wiring, but this one is low, the one next to it, so I wonder if it has something to do with that connection. I may investigate it further later, but it doesn't seem to be too concerning right now. And then 1.87 for the last one. So they seem to be relatively balanced. I don't know what the standard for good balance is when charging these things. I'm still learning how they work. You know, is it as bad as lithium, wherein an imbalance becomes quite a problem? So this seems to be a pretty good system right now. And right here I am now at 75%. Let me tilt that on this Pulsetech charger. And we got this particular charger because research suggested that it helped to keep, for long periods of time, help to keep sulfation crystals off of your battery. But in this case, it's charging a capacitor bank, which is pretty cool. I don't have to buy another charger, and it seems if I get it boosted up, I start plugged it in at about 10 volts. Seems if I get it boosted up to about 10 volts, then this guy can take over. And we'll continue to investigate how this works. Again, this here was I would consider a rather failed experiment, this 2-ohm resistor. It worked in keeping from shorting out this particular lead acid battery, but this resistor got pretty hot. In fact, it started smoking after, gosh, not even about 30 seconds. I don't really want to repeat that for your benefit. Certainly wasn't a fire, and it was just super hot to the touch, so I knocked it off, let it cool, and this setup seems to be a whole lot better right now. So again, boosted up with the solar panel, and now it's taken over with this charger pulling 36 watts, or probably about 0.6 amps now if I tick over. Yeah, 0.5 amps. So kind of a trickle charge, and I'll be curious to see at what point these LEDs start doing interesting stuff. But I'll keep you posted.